हेलो यंग लॉर्ड्स व्यूअर्स, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द एज ऑफ चौसर। द एज ऑफ चौसर इज द डाउन ऑफ द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। ब्रॉडली स्पीकिंग, दिस एज कवर्स 1340 टू 1400। दिस इज द एज व्हेन चौसर केम टू द लिटरेरी सीन, लिटरेरी स्टेज ऑफ इंग्लैंड। ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लैंड वॉज फुल ऑफ अप्स एंड डाउन्स। इट वॉज इवेंटफुल हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लैंड। The country witnesses many events and incidents during this period. Let me talk about those incidents and events in detail. The age of Chaucer witnesses the age of transition. Transition was taking place. One age was coming to an end. The medieval age was coming to an end, and the new age was trying to take birth. Medieval, which is marked by many beliefs, many blind beliefs, many superstitious beliefs, was going to end, and the new age was trying to come to light. So this age is the age of transition. Transition was taking place during this period. Wycliffe and his followers were sowing the seeds of reformation. They were making attack upon the church. Individualism was asserting itself. Military events were contributing to the growth of patriotism in the country. The industrial development gave rise to the middle classes, working classes, and the poor classes. It led to an end of feudal system in England. The second most important feature of Chaucerian age or the age of Chaucer is the growth of national sentiment. The Chaucer age witnessed the beginning of the 100 years of wars. England was at war with Scotland and France during this period. This war brought great victories in the Battle of Crecy and Poitiers. The third important feature, third important characteristic of Chaucerian age that this age saw black death, famine, and social unrest, national calamities such as black death, plagues and pestilence took place during this period. They shook the foundation of the country. Constitutional conflicts and orthodoxy came to the forefront. In 1948-49, there was Black Death. It shook social fabric of England. Many people died. They reappeared again in 1362, 1367, and 1370. Then came famine, vagrants and thieves multiplied, grew many fold in the country. As a result, there was peasants' revolt and social tension and unrest in England. The fourth important feature of the age of Chaucer is the corruption of the church. Church had become the seat of corruption in place of seat of worship and seat of religion. It had turned to the seat of power and prestige. The priests were involved in grabbing money and wealth. They were not religious. Rather, they were doing many malpractices under the garb of religion. Chaucer gives voice to this corruption in the prologue to the Canterbury Tales when he describes the people of the church in the book. The church was completely infected with corruption. Wycliffe laid an attack upon the church or upon the growing corruption of the church. The next important feature of the age of Chaucer was the coming of new learning. It was the dawn of new learning. It brought about change in the outlook of people of England. Intellectual horizon was expanding. People began to liberate themselves from the shackles of theological slavery and the church. Two Italian writers, Petrarch and Boccaccio, were the pioneers of this great revival of learning. Rinasa was already at work. Modern world was in the process of being born. Conclusion. To conclude, when we look at the period of Chaucer, the age of Chaucer, we find that there is modern note heard in this period. There was a sharper spirit of criticism in the age. The bag of the romance was coming to an end or passing. It witnessed a spirit of revolt all around. The church was losing her great hold upon the masses of people. Reformation was coming. Light of new learning was shining everywhere. This age was given proper expression by Geoffrey Chaucer, John Grover, and William Langland in their poetry, in their works. Thanks.